This dog has cancer. And so does this one. And this one. Right now, there are a few ways to treat that. Surgery, chemotherapy, or radiation. They're the very same options that people have. And you probably know someone who's been through cancer treatment. It's brutal. Take chemotherapy. It's often called a scorched earth approach. Imagine a few cancer cells in a sea of healthy ones. To attack those cells, we destroy everything around them. It's violent, it's painful. But what if there was a better way? I'm Daisy Rosario, and I'm on a mission to find tomorrow. Here, deep in the redwoods of Northern California, Andrew Hessel is trying to solve cancer. He has a solution that could be personalized, efficient, and cheap. And it's possible because of something called synthetic biology.
I know it's a terrible name because it's really just biology. But at the core of it is a machine called a DNA synthesizer, which is like a chemical printer for the DNA molecule.
That's right. Andrew wants to print DNA molecules. And it's totally possible using a machine that already exists. Imagine DNA as a tiny thread made up of Lego bricks. But there's only four different kinds of Lego bricks. A, T, G, C. The order of those bricks determines what the DNA forms. A DNA synthesizer can take a digital copy of DNA and compile the bricks one by one. But it's not just a DNA replicator. You can create custom DNA threads from scratch using the four basic building blocks.
So then it was just, what could I make with synthetic biology? What could I program using this new digital pipe that could be specific against cancer?
Good question.
Oncolytic viruses.
Oncolytic viruses infect and kill cancer cells without infecting normal cells. Andrew is trying to design personalized oncolytic viruses, custom built for each patient.
Cancer isn't just one disease.
Right.
The cancer cell is essentially a cell in your body that's gone rogue, but it's unique to you.
So for example, one person's lung cancer isn't exactly the same as someone else's.
Once it's in your body, we need a personalized way to find it and kill it specifically. Mm-hmm. And that's been a challenge.
Yeah.
Part of that challenge is the insane amount of time and money it takes to test and approve drugs. And since it costs so much to develop drugs, they tend to be aimed at a huge number of people, not just one. But when everything is digital, the cost of medicine drops dramatically.
The entire drug development pipeline for making personalized cancer medicines is just opening up and becoming more accessible, more affordable, more powerful every day.
Here in his tiny glass office in the woods, Andrew can design viruses on his own, but he still needs others to build and test them. Luckily, he doesn't have to leave his little fishbowl of cancer fighting for that to happen. Once the DNA is printed, Andrew designs an experiment to test the virus. Then, a company called Transcriptic runs it. Think of Transcriptic as a fully automated biology lab you can program over the internet.
So this is what we call a work cell here at Transcriptic. We populate it with different instruments that are used in life sciences and molecular biology research.
Basically, robots do all the work. That cuts down on errors and speeds up the process. Andrew sends specific bacteria samples that Transcriptic grows. Once grown, they attach Andrew's cancer-fighting virus to the bacteria to see how it responds. Traditionally, this process has been done by hand. Researchers would manually attach viruses to bacteria.
Before, to manipulate DNA, I would have to go into a living organism,
right,
pull out the nucleus where the DNA is kept, pull that out, open it up, pull the DNA out, and then cut and paste the physical DNA molecule. That technique is so hard and so expensive that I couldn't make that scale or cheaper.
All this efficiency is impacting science labs around the world, and it's key to accelerating Andrew's research. But before he can implement his viruses in the real world, he needs to prove that they can actually work. And that's where dogs come in. This is Dr. Bruce Smith, a veterinarian, and these are his patients.
Dogs get cancer at the same rate as people do. They get the same kinds of cancer that people do.
Specifically, Bruce is working on dogs with osteosarcoma. It's a type of bone cancer. He's using an oncolytic virus, like the ones Andrew was so interested in, to attack the dog's cancer. And he's having some success.
The survival in this tumor with current standard of care, amputation and chemotherapy, is less than 10% dogs live past a year. In our trial, we're getting closer to 25% survival beyond a year, and one of those dogs actually lived 26 months, so well over 2 years.
Wow.
That's encouraging, but not quite successful enough to move to a clinical trial. Like with humans, the cancer in each dog is slightly different, but right now at this stage, the virus he's using is the same every time. That's where Andrew comes in. He was encouraged by Bruce's research, so he called Bruce and laid out the possibilities.
Andrew said to me, I want to customize the virus to every single patient, and I want to do that on the basis of understanding that patient's tumor. Mm-hmm. And I thought, he's crazy. but crazy.
An opportunity to accelerate, learn, and advance the forward edge with dogs and cats potentially allows us to scale so much faster and prevent the types of perhaps unexpected result that could shut down a trial for years if it was to happen with a human.
The barriers to approval are a bit lower in animals, and Bruce's progress is attracting dog owners from all around the world. With enough dogs to test on, Bruce and Andrew could be printing cancer-killing viruses very soon.
That proof of concept, can we print the virus, can we actually make a virus this way, less than a year? We should be able to do that in less than a year.
There's still a lot to be done, but this progress is incredible. While Andrew moved to the woods to spend more time with his family, he's also found a tremendous amount of focus and inspiration out here. His custom-made cancer-fighting viruses could help millions of people around the world. It may seem like science fiction, but for future generations, it could make the very real effects of cancer a distant memory.